Hey guys, welcome back to my Dark Souls run-through. When we left off, we were just about to go fight the Taurus Demon. I actually ran back to the bonfire. I increased my dexterity to 10, so we could use this sword. This sword is great. You can use it at 16 strength, two-handed. It's got this really cool attack. Two-handed attack. That pretty much knocks enemies to the ground, regardless of whether you kill them. I mean, it's got a lot of reach as well. The only thing is, it's quite a heavy sword, so I'm going to need to balance out that equipment load issue with Havel's ring. So this video is actually going to be on killing Havel. Why did that do so much damage to me? I don't even know. Okay. Yeah, you obviously see the movability is a bit of an issue. But this sword just does so much damage, it kind of balances it out. I'll pick this up. But pretty much, we're going to be running back to the room that we were waiting in before the Taurus Demon, and we're going to go down and I will show you my way to kill Havel. Okay. Let's just drink. With the extra kind of reach you have with this sword, it's great for killing multiple guys at once. Is there a guy up there throwing firebombs at me? Alright. I'm just gonna go up and kill him because it's frustrating. Can you not see I'm trying to make a video here? Alright, see you later. But yeah. This sword is what I'm intending to use for a lot of the endgame stuff as well. I mean, especially for the first playthrough, we might probably use this elemental style. Ow. Just because it does a lot of damage, and to be honest, the bosses in this game, you do not need fast weapon. You need to attack it. Attack the boss at the right time. And so we will be doing that. So we're going to be using this one for the end game stuff. For the mid game stuff, we're actually going to be using the claymore that we're going to pick up in a second, just because it's a little bit faster. And as you can see at the moment, every time we attack someone with this sword, we lose all of our endurance. And so that's a bit of an issue. Also, it weighs a lot, and we need to build up stamina. So we go down here. This is where Havel is. You're gonna have to open a few doors, but it shouldn't be a big issue. Come down here, one more level. Havel's down here. As soon as you run here, he'll see you. He'll run up. You wait for him to get to you almost. He'll attack. Jump down here, and then we're going to run through this door to Dark Root Basin. Now, tactic here is bait him out. Bait him to attack. Make sure you avoid the attack. And then take a swing while he, after he attacks and he is immobilized. It's good having a sword with nice long reach. You can get him on pretty much every time without a lot of risk of getting hit. He obviously blocks with his weapon a bit. Yeah, he does that a few times. But most of the time he will just run through the door, attack, reset, and run straight back. So, I mean, there's no real risk of getting hit. You could do this with the least powerful weapon in the game, and it would kill him. And then you get his ring, which is great. Alright, come on. Nope. Okay, you gotta run back. Obviously, he's got a lot of armor, so it can take a little while. Especially when he's using his shield. But that's pretty much the tactic. Just hit him and some repeat. You kill him eventually. There's two ways to do this thing in this game. You can do things really fast and die a lot, or you can be conservative. In some things, it's easier just to be conservative. You can also attack him through that wall, which is always fun. In case he doesn't run all the way out. Sometimes he tries to attack you from there. But yeah, you can see he's about a quarter of his health is down now. Nope. I don't know whether this was intended though, or if it's a glitch, but this makes him pretty easy to fight. I've obviously intended for you to try and fight him down in this dungeon here. For it to, you know, be an enclosed fight, he traps you up against a wall, and it's not easy, but, I mean, this way, I mean, if he hits you, if he ever hits you, even if you have a shield, you'll die. Like, it's just an instant death. Even if you put all your points up to this point in strength, not strength, in, dexterity, and not dexterity, in vitality, and you have a whole heap of health, he's just gonna kill you. He does so much damage with that, what is it, dragon's tooth. So you just gotta make sure you give him a lot of distance when he does this attack, which is why it's great having this sword, because you can give him as much distance as you like. It's got such a good range. Come on, come through the doorway, please. It's a little bit annoying when he blocks that, but you can obviously try and get a little bit closer, at your own peril, I guess. Or pre-attack. Pre-attacking is always fun, but at the same time, you don't know exactly when he's going to attack, or where he's going to attack, or how close he's going to attack to you. Like that, see? I didn't even get hit by that, that was the shockwave from his attack. So, it's always the risk you take. You know, once he's attacked and you can see where he's attacked, it's very predictable, and you know you're not going to die. But, if you pre-attack, you get hit by shockwaves. If you pre-attack and you're further back, maybe. But, I don't know, I always just find it safer. I'd rather just kill him and get his ring and get it over and done with. There's some bosses you can just run in and you can attack, but the fact that he can kill you in one hit, with one attack, I'm gonna stay back. Alright. So you're gonna just bug out there. Sweet. Oh, that was close. Yeah, it's better to be safe than sorry, especially with this guy. I'd rather be alive. Now, I could go in there, and I have done it before. You backstab him, you dodge his attacks, but, you know, this is the tip and trick that I used when I was first, you know, playing this game, when I first did this guy, and it's the surefire way of killing him. And so if anyone's having trouble killing Havel, this is the way that I would do it. It also works really well with thrust weapons. So if you have a longsword or a claymore, pretty much just wait for him to attack and do the exact same thing. If anything, it's a little bit better because he seems to be more penetrable to thrust attacks than he is. Then he has slash attacks. Okay, come on, attack. Nope. Come on, man. You gotta help me out here. And obviously you can use pyromancy. Just gotta make sure you get close. I mean, it does about the same amount of damage anyway. Yeah, just remember, when you use pyromancy, you just switch back to two hands, because You don't have 24 strength at the moment, so you can't use this sword two-handed. You can't use this sword one-handed. Oh yeah. Got through your stamina there somehow. I don't know. Maybe I just got past your shield. Come on. I really would like to speed this up because I can see this taking 15 minutes and being a whole video. But I guess I'll just keep recording to show you that it can be done this way. But yeah, I think it's quite convenient that he just bugs out in that doorway there. I don't know whether it's him bugging out, but he just stops and won't go back. Yeah, 49 damage. Yep, okay. Well, we got about a third of a health bar to go. Come on. Nope. Yeah, when he backs back there, you can usually get him. Now, obviously, if you're doing this later in the game, it takes about 3 hits. Like, if you got a really good weapon, but I mean, if you got better armor, you may as well just be fighting him. I'm only doing this cautious way because I have no health, and really, this guy is the first boss type encounter that I'm gonna get loot from. I'm gonna kind of attack, so I'm very happy doing it the cautious way. Depending on how long this video is. And I mean, if it's a really long video, I might just cut some stuff out. Because... Oh god, get back! Oh man, that was close. See? Now that's what happens when you get bored. You don't want to do stuff over and over again, and you just want to kill him. You go in, you try and kill him faster, and he kills you. When you die, you have to start all over again. And I think that's one of the premises behind this game. You rush. You don't try and do things the smart way. You die. It's pretty much standard for any part of the game. You rush. You get sloppy. You die. Oh my god, though. This is taking quite a while. Oh, there we go. Get a couple more hits and he'll be dead. Come on, buddy. It's annoying that he gets you with that shockwave there, and it kind of disables you for a little bit. But yeah, I promise the next video will actually do boss and content, and it'll be great. But we will use the Zalhander for the Taurus Demon, and we will kill him very quickly with it. And I'll show you how I do that. Alright, I'd say one or two more hits to this guy, and he'll be dead. Come on. Come on, buddy. Yep, one more hit. One more hit. There we go. And he is dead. And now we have Havel's ring. Let's just equip that, and I will show you. Equipment, wait. Yep, that's a fast roll speed. And that's what we wanted. Alright, so that's going to end this video, because we wasted enough time fighting him. In the next video, we'll be traveling up these stairs, and fighting the Taurus Demon. I may run back to the bonfire in between, and level up my strength a bit, but all in all, I will see you next time. Thanks for watching. Please rate and subscribe if you liked the video. And I will see you next time.